Hi boys and girls and hi teacher, and welcome back to the Connacht GAA Skills for Schools programme, and thanks once again for getting involved. We have Cathal Craig from Roscommon with us once more this week, and you might recall last week that we learned all about the hook kick in Gaelic football. An important skill. We got some exercises last week. We set you a challenge as well to try and beat Cathal's score, and we'll have another look at that later on. But firstly, we need to remind ourselves of what was important when it comes to mastering the hook kick in Gaelic football. Cathal.
So as we looked at last week, what we're looking at is two hands on the ball, shoulder pointing towards the goals or the player you want to kick the ball to. What we're looking at is whatever foot you're kicking it with, so it's the right in my case, you put it, the ball comes down into your right hand, and you kick and strike through the ball with the instep of your foot here. So last week we looked very much in a stationary position. What we're going to look at today is where we're doing it in motion, like we do in a game. So we're going to jog into the kick and perform the hook kick.
Okay, always better to look at it than to talk about it,
yeah,
isn't it?
Definitely. Sorry about that, Dara.
Two good hook kicks there and one not so good. Look guys, it's very important that even when it goes wrong, that you keep trying. That's the whole idea of practicing these skills, so that we get better and better at them all the time. And that is throughout your footballing career, and no matter what age or what skill level you're at, Carl, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. And in any game you ever play, it's very rare that every skill will go the way you want it to go. I suppose that's the beauty of Gaelic football. You win some, you lose some, and it's just very important, particularly at your age, that when something doesn't go right, you try and improve it, you figure out what you've done wrong, and you move on and you improve.
You work on it. Well, we've three exercises for you this week again, slightly different to last week, but again, just trying to help you develop your hook kick and that masterful skill of kicking the ball in Gaelic football. Let's take a look at the first of our videos for this week.
This is an intermediate drill to practice the hook kick technique. Place three cones 20 metres from each other to form a triangle. Divide the players into pairs, one ball per pair. The drill can be adapted to practice kicking the ball in three different situations. First, the player in possession hook kicks the ball on the run while moving along a length of the triangle. Their partner remains at the far corner of the triangle in a stationary position. In the second adaptation of the drill, the player hook kicks the ball from a stationary position to their partner, who is moving along the far length of the triangle. The kicking player must judge the weight of the kick to allow their partner to catch the ball on the run. Finally, in the third adaptation, the player in possession hook kicks the ball on the run to their partner, who is also moving. For each adaptation, change the direction of the movement after a set time and get the players to kick with the opposite leg.
Okay, that's exercise number one. Let's take a look at exercise number two for this week.
This exercise requires two groups of players to play a ball over a centre zone or guard. The players use the kick pass. If the ball drops in the centre zone, that player loses a life. Using a soft or sponge ball may be suitable when introducing players to this game.
And we've one more exercise for you out on the yard. Pay close attention now so that you can get straight into it when you go outside.
This is an intermediate drill to practice the hook kick technique. Set up the drill as shown using eight cones. Position one player at each cone. Using one ball, player A in possession Hook kicks the ball to player B at the furthest away cone to one side. Player B fist passes the ball to player C alongside. Player C then hook kicks the ball to player D, and so the drill continues. Rotate the kickers and receivers after three rounds. Continue the drill in a clockwise direction for a set time. Then change the direction of the drill, getting the players to use the opposite leg. To increase the difficulty of the drill, introduce a second ball.
OK, that's enough talking and enough video watching time to get playing some football. Out to the yard with teacher, and make sure you enjoy yourself. Myself and Cahill will be waiting here to chat to you when you come back inside. See you shortly. Okay, boys and girls, well done everyone once again. Some great displays of skill out there, and we'll be keeping a close eye on how you progress over the next few weeks as well. And of course, the hook kick is what we've been learning for the last couple of weeks. Cahill set a challenge for us last week. We're going to have a look at that challenge again, because it's something that we want you to practice at home, and again try and improve whatever score you're on. Try and beat Cahill's score, and always trying to get better and practice the skills of Gaelic football. Just before we take a look at that challenge again, Cahill, just for one last time, you might just remind us what we need to remember when we're perfecting and practicing the hook kick.
Yeah, so the main things is that your shoulder is pointing towards the target that you're trying to kick. You're placing the ball into the hand of the same foot that you're kicking with. And you kick it on the instep of the foot, and that you strike right through the ball.
Okay, brilliant. Well, you might recall Cahill's challenge from last week. You might have forgotten it already, or you might have missed out last week. In any case, we're going to have another quick look at it, because it's a great one for you to try at home. Here's Cahill demonstrating.
Hi, kids. So today we're going to be doing the challenge for the hook kick. So what we're looking at here is we have two cones, one stride apart, and then you walk back 8 strides to this cone. What we're looking to do is to see how many hook kicks we can get from this cone in between the two cones out here. So Dara's going to kick the ball back to me after each of my 5. So I got 3 out of 5. Let's see, can you do any better?
So there you have it, boys and girls. That's your target now, is to go and improve on what you did last week. Maybe give it a try for the first time if you hadn't had a go yet, and maybe try and better Cahill's score as well. Cahill, it's been great having you, and thanks a million for joining us on the Skills for Schools program over the last couple of weeks.
Thanks very much, Derek.
Okay, boys and girls, well done again on another great session this afternoon, and we'll see you again soon.